One day, the Khalifa, the Abbasi Khalifa, there was no water, no rain. So he went to do Salat al-Istisqa, to pray to Allah to send rain. Imam al-Askari alayhi salam was in the prison at this time. So Imam al-Askari at this time, he's an outcast. He's, you know, sanctions, embargo, you know, we need to contain him. So put him in the prison. The rain doesn't come. This Khalifa, this Abbasi Caliph goes, he prays to Allah, Ya Allah, send rain. Like you see some people in some parts of the world, they're also praying sometimes, you know, send rain. At the season of Hajj, you see them closing everything and they say, let's pray now. Mandatory Salat, al-Istisqa. So, praying for rain. One day he goes with all the people praying from behind him, nothing happens. The next day he goes again, let's pray again, harder, harder. Nothing happens. The third day he goes, he prays hard. Nothing happens. The head of the Christians, Al-Jathaliq, the head of the Christians, he takes his priests out and he says, let's go, we will pray for rain. They go to pray, they raise their hands. The minute they raise their hands, the clouds come and start pouring rain. Okay, ajib, akhi, now. This is not really good. This does not serve, you know, the interest of our community, our society. You know, things now are at risk. So, we have a situation here, but we need to solve the situation. How do we solve it? Oh, we have some negotiation tables now we can open. So, let's go to the Imam, alayhi salam. They go to the Imam, they say, Yabna Rasulillah, Ummatu Jaddika fi khatar. The nation of your grandfather is at risk. The nation of your grandfather now is at risk. There is a problem here. People are seeing this. Us, the Muslims, we're praying. Nothing is happening. Non-Muslims are praying. Allah is accepting their dua. Their religion is becoming shaky. So we have a situation here. Why don't you come out of prison? Sorry, we apologize. There was a mistake, misunderstanding. Misunderstanding. Tafadhal, come on out here. The Imam alayhi salam said, no problem, inshallah, we will solve this issue. The next day he goes, he tells one of his Shia, one of his followers, one of his Muwaleen. He says, when you see that Jathaliq raising his hand, I want you to go and grab the thing that he has in his hand. There is something he's hiding in his hand. I want you to go. The minute you see him raising his hand, go grab it and bring it to me. He said, okay. So the man goes, Al-Jathaliq comes, the head of the priests and the Christians, he comes. The minute he raises his hand, this companion of the Imam takes the thing in his hand and brings it to the Imam, alayhi salam. So he continues to pray, nothing happens, nothing happens. Then the Imam, alayhi salam, he raises his hand for dua, and indeed, immediately, the clouds come and starts pouring rain. Then they ask the Imam, what was the thing? What is that thing in his hand? He said, apparently, the head of this group, he went by a grave of one of the prophets, and he managed to dig one of the bones of the prophet. And whenever a bone of the prophet is raised under the sky, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the water. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his awliya. And that's what was happening there. That's why he was getting rain and his dua was getting accepted. So he solved the situation. One day the Imam alayhi salam is an enemy. He's put in the prison. He's an outcast. He should be sanctioned. No one should talk to him. Anyone who speaks to him will be killed. And one day, no, he's a friend. He's an ally. He will solve our problems. You know, it all depends on what happens. And this is, subhanAllah, this is something we see happening in the world day after day. You see a nation. This nation has something interesting there, something valuable there. And so it doesn't matter what happens to that nation, what it does to its people. That's all, you know, it's all, you know, something national. And every country has its sovereignty. So we should not really do anything. However, when something interesting is there that we need to go there and we need to participate and we need to interfere, then that interest as well also dictates as well. So here we find the lessons in the Quran Exactly what we see happening in history, exactly what we see happening today. The human being, when his goals are not the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has no respect for humanity, he then will go after the interest. The interest. Fir'aun went after his own interest, whatever is suitable for him. We find that the Khalifa during Imam al-Hasan's time, alayhi salam, Imam al-Askari's time, went after his own interest. Whatever is suitable for him, whatever is convenient for him. But despite all that, people still turn to the haqq. People should still turn to the truth. People should not give up hope from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.